Hi everybody, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today we're trying a project we haven't done before. It's called Propagating a Gingko. Now this is our gingko tree. It's been here probably 20, 30 years. It's a lovely tree. We really enjoy it a lot, and we've been studying up about propagating ginkgos, and we found out last fall that our neighbor across the street has a female ginkgo. And so we took some of the seeds that he brought over here and we did plant them in a pot. They have not yet done anything. But then we noticed that last year we did a lot of trimming of the side roots on this ginkgo, and we were wondering if we could just
Here's the typical growth.
And we usually just knock these off because we don't want a limb right there.
I mean, there's a lot of them.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'd like to cut off that little limb right there and see if we could possibly... Do you have your saw on you?
Put some root hormone on it.
Yeah. I don't know if you can reach that high. No, a little more.
Let's see what I'm doing. Okay, so we may be able to strip these off, put some root hormone on there, and then see if we can get this to grow as an individual tree. That'd be cool. And we know that this is a male, and the male is the one you want. Unfortunately, what we've read was you can't tell if you have a male or a female ginkgo for about 20 years, and then suddenly it'll start blossoming, and that's what happened across the street. So this one we know is a male, and most ginkgos are raised by taking cuttings off of it and starting it so you're sure that it's a male. We have our ginkgo tree here. There are probably what are suckers off the bottom of the ginkgo tree, and we're trying to see if we can detach this from the tree and perhaps raise these as separate ginkgos. So I'm carefully trying to work my way around the three sides that aren't attached and see how far down they are attached. Unfortunately, at some point we had pea gravel in here, so we're working not only with soil but with little pea gravels. And we've got daffodil bulbs. So it seems to be an outgrowth from the tree trunk itself. We don't see any roots or anything coming out here, and we don't know if we took that whole little knob off of there if any roots would develop. So here we go, we're going to saw it off of the trunk. Maybe, like I said, there's pea gravel in here.
It's starting to wiggle, so that's a good sign. So you think once you got it cut, if you were to put root hormone on it?
Well,
possibly.
I sort of see little root here,
yeah,
see
yeah,
it?
I do too.
Yeah. It might not be down far enough yet.
Definitely loosening.
Well, it's a little looser, but not as loose as it's going to have to be. Let me take some more of soil out of there.
There's some roots right there. Yeah.
And there's another part. Pea gravel is growing right in there with it. This is the trunk, so that's not going to move. Now that we got the seedling batch off of the tree, and we know that this came from the tree side, but these roots are coming out on their own, so it makes us think that if we put this in a pot and gave it the light and the water that it needs, perhaps we can start growing a clump of little bonsais of ginkgo, which would be very cool.
Well, let's go pot them up.
Yes. We're going to be mixing our potting soil with about 1/5 of the amount of sand. Just Vic wants to make sure it's got a good stable base. Okay, so I'm not going to have them separated. I'm going to have them mixed together.
I noticed they recommended a sand potting mix mixture, potting soil mixture, with the Daphnes as well. So I have no idea why.
Nor
other than maybe to give it some sense of stability and also
drainage.
Drainage, yeah. Are you going to toss it like a pizza?
Would that I could. Putting coffee filters in the bottom because I don't want all my soil to run out those big holes. So what I'll do is I'll just set it in there, and then when I put the soil in, the water will still be able to go through it, but the soil will stay where you want it.
How many filters? Two?
It'd probably take two. Maybe one.
One in the bottom?
No, along the edge.
Oh.
Where the holes are.
See? Yeah, okay. So a pot this size, this is what, about a gallon
pot? This is a gallon, yep.
Yeah.
All right, so then I'm going to slowly add some soil in there to hold these in place. Sometimes tricky. Okay, I'm going to add some soil mixed with sand. Okay, then let me just see how deep it is here.
Mm-hmm.
Yep,
that should do it.
Okay, and then I'm going to put some of this root hormone that we spilled all along this bottom part.
Kind of like baking.
And this just stimulates the growth of roots. Hopefully. Okay, I'm going to set that in there, and then I'll just continue to add soil around the edges. It's going to need some more.
Well, this will be interesting to see if this works.
Yes, it will. Okay, back to the sand and soil mix. Okay, this. And we're going to Put some water in here. Just make sure we give it a good drink.
This is fish pond water.
Ooh, fishy motion built right in.
Is that stinky?
No, I think it's all this pollen and everything that's flying around.
I have to love the cottonwood tree that's in the neighborhood. My goodness.
Now I'm making sure that I've got enough water in there so that any little air pockets are filled with water. I'm not going to stop until I see some coming out the bottom.
Well, you know it's soaking in.
Mm-hmm. And I know that if I water it to the point of overwatering, it'll all run out the bottom, so that won't be a problem.
There it comes.
Yep. All right, are we going to keep this kind of in the shady area for the time being?
I think we should.
Mm-hmm. We're going to put this root hormone all around it. Maybe move some up here a little higher. Okay. Get that out of my way. And I don't want to just stick it in because I want the root hormone to stay on the root. And then just ferment it. Okay, and water.
Remember when we were looking for a ginkgo tree? We probably spent at least 10 years, possibly 15 years before we actually found one.
Excuse me.
And yep. It's interesting, that little nursery up in Ozaukee County, I think it was, or Washington County.
Yep.
A little triangular, whatever it was called.
Pleasant Valley.
They had two of them. So one of them now graces our backyard, and wouldn't it be beautiful if these two actually lived and worked? Now, during wintertime, are we going to have to bury these?
Yep. Just bury the pots in the ground.
Yes, okay.
We've often talked about experimenting with the ginkgos and trying to propagate them. We don't know all the research on it yet, obviously, but the opportunity arose and we thought, well, we are an eclectic experimental garden and we like to do experiments with different plants. So we're going to give this a try, and it would be really great if they worked. Then we know we can do it again. In future videos, we'll keep you updated on how they're doing. But for now, I think they're happy. So this is our experiment for today, and we're not sure if this will work or not. If you have had success or some experience with growing and propagating from other plants, we would love to hear about it. Your tips and your suggestions are taken very seriously, and they always help other people who are trying to do the same thing. So if you'd like to put those in the comments, we'd love to hear from them. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. We really appreciate all of our viewers and all the kind things that you have said about us and all the good tips you've already given us. So back to experimenting and watering. And remember, thumbs up. Thank you. Bye for now.
Connect with us on YouTube.